Ever wanted to animate your kids' drawings? Well, I'm going to show you a quick and easy way how. So to get started, all we need to do is go to sketch.metademolab.com. The next thing you need to do is obviously have a picture. You can use one of the sample pictures to see how it works, or if you want to skip that, you can go ahead and start drawing a picture that you'd like to animate on this website. I'm going to do a couple of examples right now. So first, we're going to need a picture. So let's draw one now. Not bad. Now I'm going to take a photo of this picture with my mobile phone. Now that we've got our picture, all we need to do is upload it to the website. Once we've uploaded the photo, just click next. You can either agree or disagree here. In this step, you just need to tell the website where the character is exactly, so you can close the box around your picture. Once you've done that, you can make sure that the website has selected all the parts of the picture by using the edit buttons below. You can erase parts of the body, or you can use the pencil to add parts that the website has missed. Then you click next and you have to tell the website where the head is, where the arms are, and where the legs are. And then once you've done this and click next, you then get to see your picture animated. Now there are currently only four categories on this website. You've got dance, funny, jumping, and walking. Now a lot of my students actually love drawing animals, so let's give an animal a go on this website. Don't ask. And now I'll take a picture of it with my phone. There you go. Now I've gone through the same steps as I did with the stick man, but with my animal, then you can see there's some issues with the points and it's not really clear on where the four legs actually are. So this is gonna take some time to make sure the points are as close as possible to the original picture. Now, as you can see, if you don't get the points quite right, then you're gonna have some pretty terrifying results. So some of the ways I'm gonna use this with my students, especially with my younger learners, is I'm gonna get them to first draw a person, because this seems to be the simplest way that the website understands the drawings. And I'm gonna get them to name the characters that they have drawn. Once I've got them uploaded onto the website, we're gonna be practicing some language, such as the present continuous, to describe actions. So for example, under dancing, I'm gonna get my students to describe their character with the sentence, "My character is dancing." I might even get the students to choose a song, one of their favorite songs from YouTube, and play it over the animation. So the students can come up with a phrase like, "My character is dancing to," and the name of the song. I can even go onto funny and get my students to use language such as, "My character is practicing boxing," or "My character is hungry." Then with jumping, I can obviously get my students to describe their character as jumping. And then with walking, I could even introduce some adverbs. So for example, "My character is walking slowly." "My character is walking quickly." "My character is walking funnily." Or even, "My character is hopping or skipping," which is to give them a bit more advanced language. I think my students are really gonna love this website because they're gonna really enjoy seeing the pictures that they draw in class being brought to life on the screen in front of all the other students. If you're going to use this website in your class, then make sure you take a phone or a camera to take a picture of the students' drawings. If you are teaching children this year, then I would give this website a try because I think it's gonna be a lot of fun for you and your students.